you, Mr. Jackson? How are you doing on the new medication?
Yes, it's relieving the pain, thank you.
That's good. As long as you're comfortable, that's all that matters. Your grandchildren are here to see you.
Oh, great. That should liven things up a bit.
Well, they're certainly lively children.
Grandad!
Hello, my loves. All careful. I'm not as well as I used to be.
Hi, Dad. Oh, sorry, someone's calling. I'll be back in a moment.
Daddy's always busy and working. Can you tell us more stories about when you were a little boy?
Well, that's an awfully long story.
We've got all day, Grandad.
I guess you have. Have I ever told you about the Daleks?
No, what are they?
Daleks are the evilest race ever to have existed. Their planet was destroyed in an atomic war. Then they mutated and turned into octopus-like creatures and built tanks to travel in.
Grandad, help!
No, it's all right. Look over there, there's the TARDIS, the home of Doctor Who. He's a brilliant man that saved the day and will always defeat them Daleks. Look, the Cybermen. The Doctor defeated them too. My father worked for UNIT and met the Cybermen and all sorts of aliens from beyond the stars.
Oh, Dad, stop filling their heads with these silly stories. You know they won't sleep at night hearing all about them silly space jellies.
Oh, they're not silly stories. Grandad's been to Skaro and beyond the stars.
Right, come on, kids. Say goodbye to Grandad. I have a meeting to go to.
Oh, no, we want to hear more about the Silurians and the war machines.
No, come on. It's an important business deal.
Oh, Dad.
One moment. I need to speak to the nurse about something.
Listen to everything your dad says about the Doctor. He has a very closed mind. In my study, you'll find a blue book. Keep it safe. It has all the stories about my time in the ship with the Doctor. Your father would just bin it.
Nurse, I'm getting worried about my dad. He's having these fantasies about travelling with the Doctor and meeting these things called Daleks again.
Your father is very ill. He's not got long left. You should humour him. Look, your children love his stories.
Yes, they have his overactive imagination again as well. Right, come along, girls. Say goodbye to Grandad.
Bye, Grandad. Bye, Grandad.
You look after yourself and find that book of mine and keep it safe.
Promise we will, Grandad.
You really believe in that Doctor, don't you? It's all true. The Doctor, his ship called the TARDIS and the Daleks. I'm sure it is, Mr. Jackson. There are two people here that would like to see you.
Oh, really? I wasn't expecting anyone.
Hello, James. You probably don't remember me. It was a very long time ago for both of us.
No, I'm sorry, I've never met you before.
Do you remember 76 Totters Lane and that mysterious blue box?
Have you overheard my grandchildren talking?
What about Skaro and the Daleks?
Yes, I do remember them vividly. They're like a nightmare that never stops, that the Doctor was always there to stop them.
Hello again, James. I hope I dropped you off in the right time and place. That would be the first and only time you've managed that.
Well, it was only a week or two out. Yes, Mother was beside herself. It can't be you.
No, Doctor. It is you. Hello again, James. I just thought I'd pop in and see you again.
This will most likely be your last opportunity.
Yes, I see. Sorry it's taken so long.
Oh, rubbish! You've had planets to save and much more important things to do.
Nothing is more important than your family and friends. And I've been rather lacking in finding time for both.
I was that little boy that dreamed about you and your ship of impossible things. Then one day it came true. Oh, didn't we have a narrow escape from Skaro?
Where you are, do not move.
I just found a way to operate outside the city.
Stay where you are, do not move. Obey, obey.
Ah! Doctor, look, a ship. Hey.
Yes, we did. We stopped that strand of Daleks so well and truly. Yes, but we also witnessed the last of the Fowls becoming worse than their own enemy. War and oppression can create both good and bad in all. Doctor, before I go, it's all right. Take it steady. I feel like I'm slipping in and out of consciousness. It's all right. I won't leave you. Thank you so much, Doctor. Thank you. Doctor, James has gone. Oh, there, Doctor, it's all right. James has gone off on his next awfully big adventure.